Can we move towards our next presentation?
Please, 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 next.
And this is our last presentation of the day.
Okay.
So I would like to call Dimple from Amity University, Gurugram. Her topic is emotional intelligence and resilience in college students. Dimple, please, I request you to please finish off. Try to finish off within 10 minutes.
Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Good evening, everyone. I am Dimple Mehta, MSc Clinical Psychology student at Amity University, Haryana. I firstly like to express my gratitude towards Zacks Foundation for giving me this opportunity. And as the title suggests, emotional intelligence and resilience in college students, an exploration. My idea behind this was to, because one cannot do a research solely on one topic, I chose emotional intelligence and resilience in college students to connect them and find a correlation between the two in terms of males and females, which the population was of 45 male and 45 female students, using the scale SHOUTS emotional intelligence scale and resilience scale. Coming on the introduction part, emotional intelligence was firstly coined by Aristotle in 340 BC, where he tried to
Miss Dimple ji, may I interrupt you, please?
Yes, sir.
Can you skip this introduction part? The very theoretical.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, please.
So should I come on the method?
Yeah, methodology.
Yes, sir. Okay, so the study broadly investigates emotional intelligence and resilience in college students. The research design used here is correlation research, and the type is survey research. Then the selection of the sample was done through a Google form using random sampling, where the Google form was circulated amongst undergraduate students of universities in the Delhi NCR. And there was no biasness towards gender, and preferences were given to both the genders. 45 male and 45 female candidates were, the sample was selected. A total of 95 responses were taken up. So the tools for the data collection used were SHOUTS Emotional Intelligence Scale by Nicola SHOUTS, and which had 33 items with four dimensions, which were perception of emotion in the self and others, expression of emotion, regulation of emotion, and utilization of emotion. The second scale used here was the resilience scale by Wagner and Young. It was a 25 item scale with two factors involved: personal competence and acceptance of life. The procedure here, as I said in the sampling, was done by a Google form, and the responses were collected. The total responses collected were 95. Out of them, 90 were shortlisted. The statistical analysis used here was of descriptive statistics, Pearson product moment correlation, and t-test. So the results and discussion here, as you can see from the table one, it is for the descriptive statistics. It indicates that the mean score of emotional intelligence was high in the college students, whereas the resilience score was of moderate level. Then in the table two, the correlation table, the results were such that the two variables were positively and above average correlated at significant at 0.01 level, with a correlation of 0.779, which meant that the hypothesis was accepted and the variables moved in the same direction, such that the emotional intelligence, if increased, the resilience also increased. Then I further correlated the factors of emotional intelligence and resilience, which also came out to be positively correlated and minimal of above average correlation. The table three indicates the t-test, which shows that there is a significant difference between male and female in terms of resilience, where male were more resilient than females, but there was no difference, there was no gender difference in emotional intelligence. So to conclude my study, I would like to say that my hypothesis were proven correct, and there is a correlation between emotional intelligence and resilience. There is a gender difference between resilience, yet no difference in emotional intelligence. So this, there are studies supporting my there are literature supporting my study as well. My study contributes in the field of psychology such that there are a lot of researches in emotional intelligence solely and resilience solely, but no connectivity between the two paradigms. So this study focuses on how the two variables contribute to the life of a college student and how one can cope from adversities.
Dimples, it is over?
Yes, sir.
Okay, well. EQ and resilience among college students. It is your written in title, resilience, EQ and resilience among, in. You're written in word there, it should be among.
Okay, right. Sir.
Number yes, one. Sir. Number two, you are done through Google survey.
Yes, sir.
And you have random sampling there.
Yes, sir.
So how you make sure that only college students has filled that particular performance? Suppose I am teaching.
Yes, sir.
And I can present myself there and fill that performance saying, yeah, I am a college student. How do you control that entry?
So actually, I circulated the form amongst my friends, which were of college background. And from those people, only these 95 people responded to the form. So it was quite evident that the only college student responded.
How it is random? It is a purposive, then you have a specific purpose to send only to your college students?
I circulated amongst my college friends who further circulated with their friends. And then
but that's why this is a purposive. How it is random?
Random, sir, because
no, specifically you people are purposive, either you or your friend, they are specific purposive you have. It's not a random one.
Yes, sir.
If there is a class of 51, randomly I am selecting 10, this is a random.
Yes, sir.
If I am selecting alphabet A to B, this is a purposive only, this is not a random.
Yes, sir.
You people have circulated this through Google Performa within your network only.
Yes, sir.
Right? So, if it is a random sampling and open to all, you cannot restrict the entries. Anyone can project himself or herself that I am a college student, irrespective of the age bar. Right?
Yes,
so
sir.
So, Google survey is having a delimitations about that one. So, you people, in your correlation, you have not checked about the gender difference in terms of your correlation. Resilience and emotional intelligence. In terms of gender difference, is there any correlation with gender in terms of resilience and emotional intelligence? You just compared your this gender difference in terms of your t-test.
Yes, sir.
Right. You should check their correlation gender difference also.
Yes,
when,
sir.
When
yes,
we sir. Apply t-test.
Yes. Sorry.
When we apply t-test.
Yes, sir.
What? Why we apply t-test?
Sir, to compare the means.
What the difference, Dr. Amir ji? Dr. Amir, can you ask some question about this statistical portion? Dr. Amir? Okay. So, what the difference between T and ANOVA? Yeah.
So,
anyway, छोड़ो इसको आप. So particularly जब आप ये तो आपने emotional intelligence का जो questionnaire आपने use किया है उसका शायद आपने year नहीं लिखा.
No sir.
हाँ, कभी भी बेटा जब आप किसी का नाम लिखते हैं जिसने ये questionnaire बनाया है उसके नाम के साथ कभी भी doctor मत लिखना. आपने कहीं doctor भी लिखा होगा. रिसर्च रिलेटेड एक्टिविटीज गो हैड यू आर डूइंग मास्टर्स देयर
यस सर
गुड गो हैड